welcome back to my channel. I have a very, very special guest today, my boyfriend Reese.
Hi guys.
The boyfriend tag has been the most highly requested video of all time, pretty much, for my channel. Obviously, Reese has been in a lot of my Instagram photos recently, and everyone wants to know more about him, and he's been a very, very good sport and has joined me in this video. He's a little bit nervous, but I'm trying to loosen him up, so everything's gonna be okay, and then he can turn back at any moment, and I'm here for him.
Running out the door.
Also, we're both not intentionally trying to match with our clothing and the background. My favorite color to wear is white. He likes to wear white.
And she just likes me wearing white.
No, you like it too. Yes. So whatever. First question: where did we meet? We met on Facebook. I'll let Reese take it from here.
So at first I was too scared to speak to Loz. I didn't think that she'd be into me at all. But then I guess I just took the chance. And at first she was a bit cold and not too keen. She said she was too busy and things like that. But eventually she opened up and yeah.
Well, yes, I was cold because at that point I was like not interested in dating. I didn't even want to like think about a male, a boy, anything. I wasn't interested in it. Then he was just really, really like chirpy and happy and sweet and asked me lots of questions about me rather than just talking like a lot of people just talk about themselves. He was actually wanting to know more about me. And I just thought, you know, if it doesn't go well, then it doesn't go well. But if it does go well, you know, I never know. You just got to take a chance sometimes and see how it works out. And the rest is history. Also, it's definitely important to note that Reese had no idea like about my whole YouTube thing. He doesn't even have Instagram. He pretty much only uses Facebook. So, you know, he wasn't going to be liking any YouTubers' Instagrams or, I mean, you know, Facebook pages or whatever and seeing mine pop up. I
had no clue who Lauren was.
Yeah.
To start with.
Yeah, so it kind of went in blind. Well, blind because you obviously didn't know what I look like. But
well, it was interesting when you had to tell me about the whole YouTube thing. Like, obviously, I wasn't used to that and never even knew how that worked, so.
Yeah.
To hear that.
Yeah, and it's so nice and refreshing to meet someone who kind of has no preconceived ideas about me, because it means that we're like starting fresh. It's not really fair if, and he didn't want to watch my videos until we got to know each other much better, because it's kind of unfair if he gets to watch all my videos and get to know my personality, whereas I can't do that, so he knows more about me.
I think I waited like a couple months.
Yeah, so he went about it kind of
fair. It's hard not to, that's for sure. But the second question is, where was our first date? Our official first meeting point was actually at Cottesloe Beach, but then our actual first date was at a little restaurant, Gordon Street Garage in West Perth, and had dinner, which, yeah, went pretty well.
I was just looking at him and being like little like love heart eyes emoji. Like, I was just, I don't know, when you just meet someone and you kind of get that idea, that you kind of know that they're just very similar to you.
Yeah,
in ways that are very important
clicked,
to you.
Yeah, like, it wasn't awkward at all. There wasn't just one conversation and it stopped. It was one would say something and then the other person could just keep it going and then, yeah.
It wasn't an awkward first date. And then I got home and I texted Mum. I was like, I met this new guy. And it was all really exciting because obviously it was just the last thing on my mind. And that's when you always meet someone, I think, when you're least expecting it. That's always been true for me anyway. So, yay! The third question is, where was our first kiss and how was it? Our first kiss wasn't all that memorable, but Reese is a massive cutie pie romantic, and when he actually asked me to be his girlfriend, it was because I was thinking that there's so many moments. We're on holiday for like a while.
Yeah, and for a few holidays.
Yeah, at the start of the year, and anyway, we went for this huge walk up this gigantic mountain and
in Thailand.
Yeah, in Thailand, yeah. Sorry, and it was absolutely beautiful. So we were both walking up this huge ass rock, basically this big mountain, and we got to the top and obviously it was like full of tourists, there were people everywhere. And I was pretty much fearing for my life. This rock wasn't very big, and there was so.
Were you taking selfies or just photos?
I wasn't taking selfies. I don't take selfies in public. So this rock was small, and there was lots of people on it, and I was stressed out. I was not thinking about getting asked out. I was just trying to stay alive, pretty much. I can't remember exactly what he said, but he asked me to be his girlfriend and did a really.
You can't remember what I said.
No, well, obviously you said, "Will you do me the honor of being my girlfriend" or something. Is that what you said? That's what you said.
Can't remember what I said.
That's what you said.
Yeah. Must have been a
Remembrance
day. A memorable day.
A memorous day.
A memorable day.
New words, babe. And so Benny did this amazing cute ass speech. Who am I? Yuck. Yes. Benny did a very, very sweet speech, and it was just like he's such a cutie pie. Mm. Mwah. And then we turned around after our little kissing session, and then all of these people were standing there because we were blocking the prime spot to be taking photos, and they're all just standing there. It was just like
us. I think they assumed that I proposed to you.
Like, yeah.
They didn't realise that
there was no leaning.
Just asking you out.
We went in like, a deep embrace, and everyone's just kind of like standing around like, move. So that was a very, very cute moment. Much cuter than our first kiss, because our first kiss just kind of happened. It was in the moment, but... Mm.
Which is one of those things that...
Rizzle. I always call Reese Rizzle because I always add Izzle onto the end of like every word, like Lauren Curtis Izzle.
Kmart Izzle or Camizzle.
Camizzle. Mm. Avocado Izzle. Avocizzle. Timizzle. Rizzle. Rizzle. Rizzle Minizzle. Yeah, that's enough.
So question four is, did you know that I was the one?
To be honest, I don't believe in... love at first sight, because you can love someone's appearance but you don't know anything about their personality. But it only took a few dates for me to realize that he was somebody that I could imagine spending the rest
totally
of my life
spend
with.
Our lives together.
I think from that connection, I'm a realist, like I obviously love being romantic and stuff as well, but I just think that you can't know if you love someone or just know if someone's gonna be your soulmate for the rest of your life But
if there's no connection, you're not going to be spending the rest of your life together.
So. But put it this way, once we have spent, you know, all this time together and we live together and we've, you know, we know each other inside out, obviously I think he's the one, otherwise I wouldn't be with him, so.
Yeah. Am I supposed to elaborate?
No, if you agree, then agree. Do you agree?
Of course I agree.
First impression. Sexy! What was yours?
She's alright. No. You know what my first impression is, but I was... That was at Cottesley. Yeah, my back sore. When we were walking towards you. And that's when I was like, wow! Yeah, when we were walking down to the spot where we were sitting, it was... It's sly and cheeky, but I made sure I could, check her out. And I was pretty impressed, let's just say. Amazing! That's my first impression.
Thanks.
Wow. I was actually thinking... Really? This girl wants to meet up with me? Like, no way.
Question 7. Do we have a tradition?
Probably the good night kiss.
Oh, yeah.
Probably.
We don't like going to sleep without having a good night kiss, especially me. Like, I don't care if Reese is like in like the REM stage of sleep or whatever the deep stage of sleep is. I'm waking him up to get a kiss. And there's nothing you can do about it.
The same. Good night and then goodbye kiss in the morning. I obviously leave early for work. In the morning, so they leave without giving her a kiss goodbye. Never know.
Exactly.
Could happen.
And Red Rooster chips.
Well, there's a lot of food traditions. What do we argue about the most? You can answer this one, I think.
You can answer, I've been talking enough.
It's probably the fact that Lauren leaves everything lying around the house, like dishes, clothes, it doesn't matter. What it is, but she always says she'll do it in her own time, which is never.
No, I thought
or until I have to whinge, and then if she gets fed up with my whinging, she'll finally pick it up or clean it up. Or I'll clean it for her. That's the most thing.
I thought I was clean and neat before I met him, but he's just neat and on like a whole nother like level. So my thing is,
messy.
I'm not messy at all. My apartment before I met you was not messy. It's just a case of, if I have dinner and I will leave my plate on the counter because I've just eaten, I want to relax and I just want to chill and do it later. Whereas Reese is like, might as well do it now, I'm right here. If I'm sitting in front of the TV, what am I watching?
What are you watching?
Yeah.
If it's not The Simpsons, if it's not The Simpsons or Family Guy, it's that Real Housewives. Nonsense.
Reese doesn't watch a whole lot of TV in the first place. Like, he doesn't have any like series that he has to watch or anything like that. But He likes to watch, obviously, footy and sporty stuff. Not that often, which is good, because I find it so boring. But of course, if he wants to watch it, it's not, I'm going to say you can't watch it. Cause I'm not...
We went through a phase of watching Family Feud, but we got over it pretty quickly.
Yeah, got boring after a while.
But mostly we watch movies together, I guess.
And Reese likes porn stars or hardcore porn.
Yeah. No, but like the American...
Yeah, the American, like... P-A-W-N.
Oh,
it's all the house shows as well. P-A-W-N. Let me just get that in there before he starts speaking. I just thought of a tradition!
What?
We always do this in public.
Yeah.
And then the other person has to give it back in the same amount of kisses. So, I'll do this.
That's so lame.
So lame we need me to do it in front of people, but...
it's almost like a reassurance thing.
Yeah, like if you're both... Yeah, just like... Yeah, like a little cuddle. And it's... We're not into public displays of affection because we both get shy. Like, we obviously like hold hands and kiss and like we'll hold hands and cuddle, but we're not going to make out in the middle of a shopping centre, which is fine if you want to, but we're just not like that way inclined. So, I love this question.
What dressing do I get on my salad?
Italian.
And you get balsamic or you get garlic aioli?
How much do I love garlic aioli?
More than me.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
Yeah, we're out to eat. What do I get to drink? Lauren generally has water. But if we go out for breakfast, you'll have a chai latte, a soy chai latte. And I will have...
You will have a cappuccino, without a doubt. And if we're at home, you'll get a Coke. Or you always get Cokes.
But I would more...
He more commonly gets Cokes, but if he is...
No, it's only because only certain men's shops sell it. No.
If he has access to a Dr. Pepper, he'll get a Dr. Pepper or a Cherry Coke.
Yeah, just the bomb.
The bomb! If I was collecting anything, what would it be?
Other than horror movies and makeup, it would be clothes, shoes... There's a lot of stuff.
Any making typical, me sound so ridiculous.
Typical girl stuff, I guess. But other than that...
I don't collect clothing, I just buy it because I need clothes.
Yeah, if you collect. If there was anything you could collect, it would be cars. Because your love of cars is ridiculous. There's not anywhere to go without Lauren commenting or admiring a car, like a little feature or...
Nice wheels. Oh, that's gross. Nice colour. Oh,
yeah,
cool.
Everywhere we go.
Oh, what would you collect? You would collect... Don't say anything, it's going to ruin it for me. You would collect... Oh, I know this. Watches!
Yeah.
Watches! Duh, I knew it was like an easy one. Reese loves watches. He has a nice little watch collection. That's what Reese collects. Oh, I'm so tired.
No.
What is my favourite sports team? Lions or something?
Melbourne Demons.
Melbourne Demons?
Yeah, because they're one of the first clubs in
I've never heard of Demons playing in AFL.
Yeah, they're the original, one of the original Demons. Clubs. Yeah, one of the original.
That's right, I swear I've never heard of that before in my life. Demons.
Melbourne Demons, yeah. Look it up, Google it.
That's
doesn't
weird.
Believe me.
Well, you just answered your own question about yourself, so that doesn't really count, but I don't like sports, so I don't have one. I just like... Whoever's winning. That's my favourite team. I'm just prepping Reese, giving him some...
I'm going to have a sore back. I'm sitting in this most uncomfortable chair. Isn't she pretty?
Oh, you cutie. What is my eye colour?
Well, it changes... Not changes, but it's different in different lighting. But obviously it's blue, but it's... When you look at the ocean, you see that greeny blue tinge. That's exactly what it's like. That's my favourite thing about Loz.
Aww.
Those amazing eyes.
Cutie pie. Can you see his eyelashes? His eyelashes are like out to the other side of the world. They're just so long and luscious.
Anyway, back to the eye colour.
No, it looks like he has eyelash extensions. And his eyes are all big and brown, like an innocent little deer. Deer? Bambi?
Deer.
Okay, I think I'm going to tease a bit too far, but you know what I mean. You have beautiful brown eyes and certain lights, they go to like a lighter, kind of like a chestnutty shade of brown.
What is something that I do that you don't like?
Okay! Let's begin! I'm kidding.
I think you've covered yours that I don't like. Pretty much the whole picking up after yourself and cleaning and...
And I don't like that he nags me about that, because I have to live my life and I have to worry about it. So this doesn't annoy me, but I guess I just don't like it because it's not how it should be. But I guess Reese doesn't see himself in the way that I see him. I obviously think he's incredible and he doesn't see that, see that in himself as much as I wish he would, because he is incredible and he leaves the best impression. After meeting anyone in my life, he's just one in a million, and so when he doesn't he obviously always compliments me and, you know, sees me in this light, but then he doesn't see himself in that light, and everyone else does. I am one lucky gal. But there's not really much that I don't like about him at all, because it took me a long time to even think of that, and Reese had to help me. I think that's why we're such a good fit, because I know that I'm a very particular kind of person, and just, at least within my own previous dating, you know, history, I've never really met someone that is so similar to me, and I kind of thought it was just not going to happen. Reese comes along and is just exactly what I had
hoped for. It's crazy how similar we are, though.
Yeah. And to our detriment, if that's the right way to use it sometimes, we obviously, because when you're so similar to someone, you argue about the same things, because we're both like stubborn about stupid things, we're sensitive about things, and so, yeah, but on a whole, there's just not much to complain about, because we just get along so well, and we just want it to work so much that we don't let little things that could possibly annoy us get in the way. That brings us to the end of the video.
Yay! Finally. No, wasn't as bad as I thought.
So yes, thank you, Bebe, for coming on. He can't kiss me on my lips because I've got lipstick on. He knows that it's just not
frustrating.
Nah.
Nah.
Nah, it's alright. So that is the end of the video. I hope you guys liked it. I hope it was worth the wait and it was as exciting as you might have hoped it would be. That's my first ever boyfriend tag, so Reese has popped the cherry. Yay.
Popped the cherry.
So I will see you in my next video, and Reese will see you sometime soon, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'll drag him into another video sometime. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you all very soon.
Bye.